In the small town of Grapeview, Washington State, in the Pacific Northwest of the USA, lives a lady who suffered from a deadly condition at birth. Dawn Shaw was born with a huge facial tumor that needed years of painful surgery. It left her with a severe facial disfigurement, and now she's terrified of surgery. Almost 30 years on, can she bear to go through one more operation to help her close her left eye?
When I was born, I had a growth in the cheek neck area. My dad tells me it was about the size of his fist.
Left untreated, the serious condition would have killed her.
It was blocking my airway. So they removed the growth and determined that it was a rare type of tumor called a teratoma.
Doctors had to be sure they removed every piece of the teratoma if Dawn was going to survive. So much of her face was removed, it left Dawn unrecognizable.
I always compare it to someone carving a Halloween pumpkin, just where you have the shell and you just take the top off and you take a spoon and you pull out all the pulp and the seeds. And that's what they did, and they basically left the shell of skin. I literally was left with the jaw not attached on one side. I'm basically paralyzed on my left side.
Dawn's struggles had only just begun. Multiple serious operations were to follow.
I mean, I was in the hospital a lot when I was an infant.
As if things hadn't been tough enough, Dawn had to endure cruel bullying because of the way she looked.
Where I had a kid who would literally wait for me at the school when I was on my way to the bus and just say mean things about, you know, how could I stand to look at myself and you're so ugly, and it was very hurtful.
It was deeply upsetting, and on top of the bullying, throughout her teens, Dawn had dozens of operations. She endured immense physical pain, and then one procedure went disastrously wrong.
Those 2 days in intensive care were very intense, very painful. And that's when I came to the conclusion that the amount of difference that was being made wasn't worth the cost.
Dawn's fortunes were about to change for the better, after a chance meeting led to marriage.
Dawn and I have been together for, I want to say, 23 years, roughly. We met doing community theater. That was when I first saw Dawn, climbing up a ladder in the middle of the audience, stringing lights. So it made an impression.
For Ian, it was love at first sight, and Dawn began her first proper relationship.
I am the one who finally asked him if he wanted to get married. Ian tells me that my face was never an issue for him. I've discovered that once you get to know someone, you really don't see their appearance quite so much. It just becomes part of their identity.
Recently, Dawn's been suffering excessive tearing in her left eye, because numerous surgeries have left her paralyzed down the left side of her face. And although she remains fearful of surgery, today she's at the University of Washington Medical Center to see if doctors can offer her any help with closing her eye.
When Dawn had her surgery, would have been considered the early days of microsurgery. And while some of the procedures were possible, they were much rarer than they are today.
We probably can't make you lift your eyebrow again. There isn't a good operation for that. There are some good operations for the eye. For example, your lower eyelid is drooping. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And one of the operations that we do for that is very simple. We take a piece of tendon from your arm and we sling it into the lower eyelid, attach it to the bone, attach it to the ligament at the corner of your eye, and it lifts the whole lower eyelid and puts it in a better position.
The operation to help her eye seems fairly straightforward, but following years of painful surgery, it remains a difficult decision for Dawn. Having suffered from a life-threatening face tumour at birth, years of painful operations have left Dawn Shaw terrified of surgery.
We are.
But because the left side of her face is paralysed, she can't close her left eye and is suffering excessive tearing. Having seen specialists, can she face one more operation? 3 days later, and Dawn has made up her mind about surgery.
The surgery I have chosen to have is strictly because of a health and quality of life issue.
It's been almost 30 years since the terrifying final surgery that left Dawn in extreme pain for days. She's understandably anxious.
I'm a little nervous about today's surgery because it's been 29 years since I've had surgery on my face. I've had plenty of experience with needles. I don't like them. I've gotten a little tired of rearranging body parts. It's a painful process.
Surgery takes little more than an hour.
Well, I mean, I hope it's a complete success and that her eye returns to normal function, and if anything, actually seals better and better protected.
Yeah.
A short while later, Dawn wakes from the anesthetic.
I'm not feeling as bad as I could. I've certainly woken up with worse situations. I'm just more a little uncomfortable. I've been told that everything has gone exactly as it should have.
Yeah. We can already see a visible change. The lower part of the eyelid's definitely higher than it used to be.
It's a huge relief that Dawn's operation is a success. And having suffered so many painful setbacks over the years, she remains positive for the future.
I am grateful that I'm able-bodied. I am grateful that, for the most part, medically, I've done pretty well. I am high on life.
Just another family enjoying the World Heritage Site of the old town in Dubrovnik with their friends. Seemingly all is normal, but incredibly, their son, who at 60 centimeters high looks like a toddler, is actually already 5 years old.
Ne, ja imam Majevski sindrom tip 2. Ne znamo što nosi budućnost, to će nam sam Nevio pokazat.
Majevski syndrome is an extremely rare type of dwarfism, with sometimes lethal side effects.
Ta bolest nije toliko razvijena, niti je poznata, tako da živimo iz dana u dan.
When Teja and Davrin had the happy news that they were to be parents, they were delighted. Everything appeared normal, until they went for a scan.
Trudnoća je tekla uredno sve do četvrtog mjeseca. U četvrtom mjesecu smo saznali da imamo zastoj u rastu.
When he was born, Nevio was tiny, and his internal organs were uniformly smaller than average.
Na sve što smo sumnjali, radili smo i amniocentezu da vidimo da nije možda Downov sindrom ili neki, međutim, sve to pokazalo zdravo muško dijete.
Throughout the first few years of his life, medics monitoring his progress struggled to diagnose him.
Nakon ponavljajućih kontrola, kroz koje se uvijek pratilo samo rast i fizički razvoj, u dobi od 3 godine profesor Dumić konačno postavio dijagnozu.
It was Majewski syndrome, which was first noted in the 1800s. The symptoms were the same. Sufferers were tiny but perfectly formed, and their novelty value meant they were often put on show. Alarmingly, a year ago, Nevio began to show signs of stiffness in his joints. He faced his first of a series of hip operations.
Sljedeća operacija bi bila krajem ljeta, jer moramo učiniti pauzu od 6 mjeseci od svih ovih silnih anestezija.
Since the hip operations, Nevio hasn't shown any new symptoms.